Mary, don't be afraid. You have no reason to be afraid. God is with you. I am Gabriel, God's angel. I have come to tell you that God loves you and has chosen you. You'll become pregnant and have a baby boy. You will name him Jesus. He will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord will give you him to the throne of ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and his kingdom will have no end.
I don't understand. How can this be? Joseph and I are not married.
The Holy Spirit will come upon you, the power of the highest hover over you. The baby will be called the Holy Son of God.
Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word.
Praise God. She said yes. God's peace and love to Mary.
What do I tell Joseph?
I can't believe the stories Mary telling me. Mary pregnant? This is not gonna be good. She tells me that's all okay. But it's God's child. God's child! If I break the engagement publicly, she'll be harmed. I don't want to come to Mary. My only option is to marry her and divorce her quietly. But then she'll be disgraced. I don't want that either. Oh, Mary, what am I going to do?
Joseph, Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to marry Mary. She is pregnant and will give birth to God's son. You will name him Jesus. He will be the savior of all people in the world. He will be called Emmanuel, which means God is with us.
I will marry Mary. I will marry Mary, and then we'll have a son and we'll name him Jesus. I need to tell Mary.
Citizens of Rome, it is I, your Lord and Savior, Good Shepherd, Light, Way, and Prince of Peace, Caesar Augustus.
Wow!
Impressive!
Impressive.
Yeah!
Impressive. Totally not.
First, I want to say you're welcome for all the great things I've done for you. There's never been an emperor as powerful and glorious as me. My empire is vast, you people are obedient, I am saving you all. All of you. And you owe me so much. So much. Citizens, I want to count you. Yes, let's get a good head count so you can all pay me what I am owed.
What?
Count us.
What are we, sheep?
Yes. Go to your hometown and register your family so that you can show proper appreciation of my awesomeness. I decree it to be so. Farewell, my faithful children. May you know my magnificent ways. Farewell!
Great. Now we have to travel many days to be counted so this guy can become richer.
Oh, great.
I hope he finds a place soon. This baby is not gonna wait much longer.
Okay, good news. I think I found a place for us to stay.
Finally, thank goodness. Where are we staying? Oh, and did you get the room from the nice inn that I like? The one that has the waffle breakfast?
Not exactly. Oh. It was full.
Oh no, what are we gonna do? Sleep outside with shepherds? Sleep in a stable with donkeys?
What? Ah, no. Who would do that?
Joseph, the baby is coming soon.
I know. The guest rooms are full. But I found an innkeeper who will stay in his room.
Oh, good.
Yeah, it's a nice place. Lots of hay. And maybe a few animals.
Guarding their sheep. All at once, an angel came down to them from the Lord, and the brightness of the Lord's glory flashed around them. The shepherds were frightened, but the angel said to them,
"Don't be afraid. I have good news for you, which will make everyone happy. On this very day, a Savior was born. He is Christ the Lord. You will know who he is because you will find him dressed in baby clothes and lying in a bed of hay." Praise God in heaven. Peace on earth. Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
Say it really loud.
Glory to God.
Y'all saw that, right?
Did you hear the angel say God's son had been born tonight?
Yeah, I heard about that.
Let's go. What are we waiting for? Let's go find this baby born in Bethlehem.
Look, a star. The star looks like it's over the city of Bethlehem.
The shepherds ran all the way to Bethlehem, only stopping when they found the stable. They paused in the entrance and saw Mary and Joseph. They went in. There was no need to say anything. It was as if Mary and Joseph were expecting them. They gathered around the manger and saw a tiny newborn baby swaddled in strips of cloth lying on the hay. Instinctively, they sank to their knees.
Glory to God. This is the Savior of the world.
His name's Jesus.
As the baby Jesus slept, the shepherds told Mary and Joseph everything that happened that night. They talked about the angels and the beautiful singing. They talked about the birth of Jesus, God's own son. They praised God together for all that had happened. As dawn broke and the shepherds left the stable, Mary closed her eyes to rest.
Nothing is impossible with God.
Hello, and welcome. This is our observatory. We are the wise men.
Wise people. The magi.
We are really more like scientists.
Astronomen? Whatever, we study the stars.
We study the stars so well that when something changes, we notice immediately.
And we just noticed a new star. We must follow our scientific instincts and find out where this new star is in the sky.
We now begin our journey.
Are we there yet?
You literally just asked that.
Now?
Oh. Yes, it looks like we are here.
Here it is, Bethlehem. Let's look up the local king so we can get some more information.
Did somebody say king? That would be me. I'm the big cheese around here. Everybody is talking about it. They say I'm such a powerful king, but I'm the best king Bethlehem has ever seen.
We got it, best king ever.
So, we're here because we are looking for the newly born king.
The child born king of the Jews.
We observed this star, his star at its rising.
And we have come to honor him.
Ah, would you excuse me for a moment? I have to make a cell phone call. Hey, put me through to my smart people. Hi, this is your king, the very best king. I need to know, according to your research, where is the Messiah supposed to be born? Bethlehem? Are you sure? Bye. Hi, wise folks. You go to this child, king of the Jews, and praises of his honor. And when you come back, I too would like to praise him.
Sure. Okay.
Yeah, we can do that for you. Let's get out of here.
When we left Herod, he decided to sit around and be jealous and plan his revenge.
He felt very threatened. There was a new leader that people were excited to meet.
But we found Jesus and brought his gifts to the special child.
We brought gold,
frankincense,
and myrrh.
Usually these gifts are for royalty.
Powerful people.
Grown men.
But we brought these tiny gifts. We brought these gifts to a tiny, weak, oppressed child.
Even though we didn't know exactly what was going on, we knew he was important.
This good news would turn everything upside down.
And by the way, we didn't return to that wicked King Herod.
Nope, no way. We were warned in a dream to take a different way home.
You might say we took a scenic route.
And now we return to watching the stars.
We don't know how quickly all of these events happened. Some folks say that the wise ones didn't make it to Bethlehem for over a year. If it did take over a year, the wise ones would not have found Jesus in a manger. We know that Jesus' birth was special. Mary and Joseph knew that God had blessed them in a most wonderful way. Mary and Joseph were the parents of Jesus, the Son of God. Angels told of the glorious birth. Shepherds and their flocks came to adore the baby, and wise ones brought gifts. Today, we retell this story as a reminder of God's greatest gift to us, Jesus, God with us.
Let us pray, O Lord, our God, with Mary and Joseph, angels and shepherds, and the animals in the stable. We gather around your Son, born with us. Bless us with your holy presence and inspire us to help those who have no place to dwell. Be with us that we might share Christ's love with all the world, for he is our light and salvation. Glory to the heaven and peace on earth, now and forever. Amen.
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 Amen. Amen.